Recorded Books and One-Click Digital present Mr. Louie Is Screwy by Dan Gutman, pictures by Jim Palot, and read by Jared Goldsmith.
Chapter 1. The H Word and the L Word. My name is AJ, and I hate school. I hate school, I told my friend Ryan, who will eat anything, even stuff that isn't food.
Me too,
he said. We were walking to elementary school with our friend Michael, who never ties his shoes.
Me three, said Michael. I hate school too.
Well, I hate school more than you guys do, I said.
Nobody hates school more than me, said Ryan.
I hated school before you guys hated school, said Michael.
Oh yeah, I told him. I hated school before you were even born. Anytime you want to win an argument, just tell the other person you did something before they were born. It works every time. That's the first rule of being a kid. Asterisk. This is called a footnote, because when you see it, you're supposed to look down. To see your foot, you have to look down too.
Groovy, somebody said as we were about to cross Walnut Street. I can dig where you dudes are coming from.
It was Mr. Louie, our crossing guard. He was standing at the corner of Walnut Street in front of the school. Mr. Louie always wears sandals and a tie-dyed shirt. He held up his guitar, which he uses as a stop sign.
But it's a drag to use the H word, Mr. Louie told us. Hate is a downer, man. You should say love.
Ugh, Mr. Louie said the L word. Ew, we all yelled.
There's too much hate in the world, Mr. Louie explained, and not enough love.
Mr. Louie used to be a judge, but he quit because he said there were too many bad vibes, whatever they are. That's when he became a crossing guard. The L word is for girls, I said.
Love is for everyone, Mr. Louie told us. Do you know why I love so much? Every morning, I take a love potion. You dudes should take some, too.
No thanks, we all said. I never heard of a love potion. Maybe Mr. Louie was yanking our chain.
School is cool, he said. You dudes should say you love school.
I'm not saying the L word out loud, I announced.
AJ, Mr. Louie told me, if you don't say I love school, I'm gonna tell everybody you love Andrea.
Ew! Andrea Young is this really annoying girl in my class with curly brown hair. I don't love Andrea. I don't even like Andrea. I hate Andrea. So I sure didn't want Mr. Louie telling everybody I love her.
Okay, I said quietly so nobody else would hear. I love school.
Out of sight, said Mr. Louie. Give me some skin, AJ. Feel the love.
Ooh, Ryan said. AJ is in love with school. When are you gonna get married to the school, AJ?
Asked Michael. If those guys weren't my best friends, I would hate them. Asterisk. What are you looking down here for? The story's up there, dumbhead. Chapter 2. I Hate Love. When we got to class, our teacher, Miss Daisy, was talking with Mr. Mackey, the reading specialist. Reading is boring, but Mr. Mackey loves reading so much, he walks around reading soup cans. He's weird. Do we have reading today? I asked him.
No, Mr. Mackey told me. We have an assembly.
An assembly is when everybody assembles in the all-purpose room, so it has the perfect name. After the morning announcements, we had to walk 1,000,000 miles to the all-purpose room. It looked weird. There were peace signs, flowers, and lava lamps all over the stage.
Crisscross applesauce, Miss Daisy told us as we sat down. The teachers used to tell us to sit Indian style, but they stopped because they thought Indians might get mad. Then they told us to sit like pretzels. I guess some pretzels got mad because now the teachers just say crisscross applesauce. I hope applesauce doesn't get mad. Asterisk. Made you look down. Man, you'll fall for anything. Once everybody was seated, the strangest thing in the history of the world happened. Our principal, Mr. Klutz, got up on stage. Well, that wasn't the strange part. Mr. Klutz gets up on stage all the time. The strange part was that he had hair all the way down to his shoulders. We knew Mr. Klutz was wearing a wig, because just yesterday, he was completely bald. Nobody can grow hair that fast. Mr. Klutz held up his hand and made a peace sign, which means shut up.
Valentine's Day.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.